actually come and discuss my project work there.
Okay. Yes, madam, you can start with this.
Everybody. Okay, thank you, Principal Madam. Over to Atharva and Ishwari. Please begin with the session.
Yes, ma'am. A very good afternoon, respected Principal. Principal and the chairperson of Career Garden Cell, Dr. Sudha Rathod, ma'am, our shining alumni and panelists of the day, convener of Career Garden Cell, Dr. Vandana Jain, ma'am, faculty member of Career Garden Cell, Dr. Mahinda Prajapati, sir, Amjad Ali, sir, Surat, sir, Pyusha, ma'am, and all the other faculty member and all the students of third year and fourth year. As Abraham Lincoln once said, the best way to predict the future is to create it. And thereby, I extend my warmest welcome to everyone attending the first Career Guidance webinar of academic year 21-22.
Well, sir Ishwari, I would like to invite our principal madam, Dr. Sudha Rathod ma'am, who is always a constant source of motivation and support for all of us throughout our journey, for addressing the gathering. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Adar. So today we are having all alumni with us to guide our students for better their studies, jobs. So this is first of its kind of where all our alumni are the speakers. So this gives me a lot of pleasure that our students are only the guide for our juniors, your juniors. And main motive of this session is just to improve in the placement of and higher studies, quality of job secured by our students, and they are opting. So this all will be improved of kind of sessions. So this is the first of its kind of session we have started with, and now we will go ahead with. And so in many areas we ourselves, and this is not the developed college, we are developing college and now reaching to the excellence. Everybody is working so hard and everybody is working hard and they have a lot of head to continue. Yesterday only we had a meeting with our management, and when Dr. Azim Khan saw the numbers of committees on each faculty, he was astonished to see all these things, and he started asking me, how this is possible, madam? I wanted to know. So whenever I will come, you just show me how are you pursuing so many things together. So yes, this is the time when teacher is required to do so many other things, 50% teaching and 50% other jobs, but it is required. You cannot deny. So to get all good quality of education, good quality of jobs, good quality of higher studies, we need to work on so many facets. Even sir was ready to go for entrepreneur sale, like where innovation sale can be started. So maybe in day or day after tomorrow, he will be there with us in the campus and he will speak on how to go ahead with the entrepreneurship sale and innovation in our college. So this is how I am also happy to see that our teachers are also cooperating so much, and whatever is told to them, they are also doing with interest. And this is one of the example of coordination between principal and teachers and students. So over to you, madam. Thank you
for enlightening all of us and for always being us to do more and more activities for the students. So everyone can, everyone will agree that OCC is always very much proactive for the students. So we'll begin with the next activity. Next step. Over to Ishwari and Atharva.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Vandana, ma'am. Thank you, Principal, ma'am, for your kind words. Thank you, ma'am, for your kind words. Now we would like to go ahead with the program. We will now like to introduce our panelists of the day. Over to you, Ishwari.
I request to share the screen. Yeah. The first guest on the panelist is Mr. Kaushik Kuche. Sir is an alumni of Oriental College of Pharmacy. and MS specialization in pharmaceutics from Naipar, Ahmedabad, and currently pursuing PhD in pharmaceutics from Naipar, Mohali. Over to you, Atharva.
We also have Mr. Aditya Singh, another alumni of Oriental College of Pharmacy, Sanpada. Sir has also completed an MS specialization in pharmacology and toxicology from Naipa, Hyderabad, and currently pursuing a PhD from Naipa, Ahmedabad.
We also have Ms. Mansi Umarji. Ma'am is an alumni of Oriental College of Pharmacy, Sanpada, and currently pursuing MS specialization in pharmaceutics from Naipa, Guwahati.
Our next guest is Mr. Abhinav Gupta. Once again, we have an alumni of Oriental College of Pharmacy. Sir is also an alumni in MBA in Pharmaceutical Management from NMIMS, Mumbai.
The last guest on the panelist is Mr. Burhanuddin Phagalwala. Sir is also Oriental College of Pharmacy, Sanpada's alumni, and has completed MBA in Pharmaceutical Management from Naipa, Mohali. Now, I would like to call upon Kaushik sir to kindly set the webinar in motion. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much for your kind introduction. If panelists allow me, I would like to share my screen. If that is okay with you all. Ma'am, shall I share my screen?
Yes, Kaushik. Yes, Kaushik. Mahendra sir is handling the meeting. Mahendra sir, please do the
next one. Okay. So, is my screen visible?
Yes.
Yes.
So a very good afternoon to all the students who are attending this session. Firstly, I would like to express how happy I am to be a part of Oriental College of Pharmacy again. That was the only place from where my pharmacy career actually began. So I would like to thank each and every faculty member for guiding, for teaching, and for helping me, which assisted me to progress in my career in pharmacy. So thank you all. So with this, let's begin with the talk for the today. The topic of discussion today here is the career guidance for NIPA aspirants. So I have tried to make this presentation as short as possible, as crisp as possible. And I think this would answer majority of the questions which the students will have. So yes, starting off with the presentation, here is the general roadmap, which generally the fresh B-Pharm graduates usually have after they complete their B-Pharma. Usually the students may go for higher studies, or they may pursue jobs, or they may have certain other plans, which includes starting up with their own ventures or preparing for certain government jobs. So since this topic of discussion here deals with the higher studies, we'll be restricting our discussion towards higher studies only. So under higher studies, one could actually go for pursuing master's or M.Pharm, or one could actually opt for MBA Pharm, or one can actually try for PG diplomas. So for pursuing MS or M.Pharm, I think NIPAR, BEDS, ICT, Punjab University, Manipal are the one which one should actually try their, these are the institutes which one should actually try for. For MBA, apart from NIPAR and NMIMS, there are many other institutes which I think Abhinav and Buran would be talking about in their session. And if students are interested, then they can also, pursue their PG diplomas through Jamia, NALSAR or Manipal universities. These are the well-reputed universities which actually give postgraduate diplomas in several fields like IPR, pharmacovigilance, and say regulatories and so on. So if students are interested in that, then I would recommend them to visit their university sites and get their information about their respective courses from there. Now, since I have pursued myself in MS Pharm, so I would be focusing this presentation both towards MS and MS Pharm. So based on my personal opinion, I think if anyone is interested in doing MS Pharm, these are the four institutes which one should look for. Starting off with NIPAR. NIPAR, as we all know, requires a qualifying exam, that is GPAT. And once you qualify GPAT, then you would have to give a NIPAR JEE exam. And based on the rank which you get in IPA JEE, respective stream at and respective campus, I mean, you will be getting your seat. Similar goes with the BITS. The BIT conducts examination under the title called as BITS HD, where HD is the abbreviation for a higher degree exam. And one more thing is that the BITS BITS HD, scoring a good GPAT and GATE score would be acting as an additional weightage. Similarly, for ICT and IIT BHU, GPAT are the main entrance exam, which would be, I mean, based on which you will be getting your admission. So since for past 6 years, I have been associated with NIPER. First 2 years, I have done my master's at NIPER Ahmedabad. And after that, I am pursuing my PhD at NIPER SAS Nagar. So here, I would like to tell you in brief about the NIPER. NIPER is basically, NIPERs are basically established by the Act of and Parliament by the Government of India. And in the year 1998, NIPER SAS Nagar was established as a center of excellence for imparting higher education research and development in pharmaceutical sciences and management. After 1998, in the year 2007 and 2008, other NIPERs like Raebareli, Hajipur, Guwahati, Kolkata, Hyderabad, and Ahmedabad were also established. Now since I have been associated with NIPER SAS Nagar, I'll be talking about NIPER SAS Nagar only. So the NIPER SAS Nagar offers several courses like MS Pharm courses in medicinal chemistry, natural products, traditional medicine, pharmaceutical analysis, and pharmaceutical analysis, pharmacology and toxicology, regulatory toxicology, pharmaceutics, biotechnology, and pharmacoinformatics. They also offer M Pharm courses in pharmacy practice, clinical research, and pharm technology formulations. Now here I would like to mention that the pharm technology formulations and pharmaceutics are almost the same courses. The only difference is that the pharm technology formulations have few additional subjects as compared to that of the pharmaceutics. But rest, both the streams are almost same. Apart from that, NIPER SAS Nagar also offers an MTech pharma program in pharm technology, that is process chemistry, and pharm technology biotechnology. Apart from that, NIPER SAS Nagar also have MBA Pharm, which deals with the pharmaceutical management studies. Apart from that, PhD programs are also being offered, for all the streams, as we have mentioned. Recently, NIPER SAS Nagar has also started an MTech program for the medical devices as well. So this is a relatively new field, which has now started on the campus. So here is the seat-wise distribution of, for each stream. There are around 26 seats for medicinal chemistry. There are 14 seats for natural products. 5 seats for traditional medicine, at around 9 seats for pharmaceutical analysis. Pharmacology and toxicology has 20 seats. Regulatory toxicology has 9. Pharmaceutics has 22 seats. Biotechnology has 37 seats. Pharmacoinformatics has 19 seats. Whereas in case of MTech cases, there are 17 and 11 seats in PTPT and PTBT. Speaking of MTech, there are 10 seats. Speaking of M-Pharm degrees, in pharmacy practice, there are 9 seats. In pharmaceutical technology formulations, there are 7 seats. And in clinical research, there are 9 seats. And rest 46 seats are in pharmaceutical management. So overall, there are 270 admissions each year, which happens at NIPER SAS Nagar. So if you want to be a part of NIPER SAS Nagar, make sure that you score a NIPER rank well within 270. So speaking of eligibility criteria, the basic requirement is the same as we all know. That is, the candidate should be GPAT or GATE or NET qualified. He or she should be having at least more than 60% or more than 6.5 CGPA. For students awaiting their final year results, which is usually the case with Mumbai University students, for them, they need to send confidential results from official email ID of their respective university registrar before the final counseling. There are certain relaxations also for SC ST category students. The CGPA allowed is of around 6.25 and marks of around 55 are considered eligible. Also for physically handicapped students, there is a relaxation in CGPA till 5.75 and in marks the relaxation is still 50%. There are also reservations for other categories as well, which are again based on the provisions made by our Government of India. So speaking of cutoff and selections, if we say as such, there are no, I mean, we cannot directly say that, yes, I mean, this is the cutoff for NIPER. Actually, in NIPER, we do not have cutoffs. The NIPER just provides us with the mark sheet, which mentions your rank. And based on your rank only, you will be getting the seat. So we cannot directly say whether you qualify a NIPER exam or you don't qualify. Like what we get in GPAT, right? Like in GPAT, we get a certificate which mentions that you have qualified. But in NIPER, there is just a certificate which mentions your rank. So based on that rank only, you will be getting your seat. Why I'm saying that cutoffs are dynamic and may change each year is, the best example I can give you is of this year's only. None of the students from top 20 selected NIPER Mohali analysis. The reason being is that the students came to know that Professor Saranjit Singh, which is a well-known personality in the field of pharmaceutical analysis, now he'll be retiring this month. So actually this information was passed on to the students very well. So, due to that reason, student didn't opt for pharmaceutical analysis, and due to which the whole cutoff system got shuffled. So it's better that we don't actually rely on the cutoffs, which are generally being given by other, agencies or certain other classes. It is actually dynamic and no one can actually predict, at what year, what would be the cutoff, right? So it's better that we don't actually, rely on the cutoffs only. Apart from that, rather than believing in cutoff, it is important that one must be aware of the current statuses of each NIPER before you select. Like as I've told you, in case of Professor Saranjit Singh, like the information got leaked. The information was then passed on to the students, and due to which the students didn't opt for NIPER Mohali pharmaceutical analysis. So, these are small informations which one should actually look into. And based on that only, you should make your decisions, right? The third point which I would like to discuss here is the selection of seat. The selection of seat must be based on your stream of interest and not based on the campus perception, right? Now, this is a very crucial point which I'm saying is because, most of the time what happens is the student judges an institute based on its campus. Now, everyone thinks that the NIPER Mohali has a very big campus. So yes, the streams or the information which they'll be getting at NIPER Mohali would be best as compared to NIPER Ahmedabad or say Hyderabad, which is not always true. The important thing is your stream of interest. How interested are you in your stream? So based on that only, you should select your campus. The fourth thing is that the selection should also be based on the research interest, which actually coincides with my third point. That is, like, if you're actually interested in pharmaceutics and say, suppose if you're not getting a seat in pharmaceutics, NIPER Mohali, then you should actually go for pharmaceutics either in Ahmedabad or in Hyderabad or Kolkata. You should never try to leave your stream just for the sake of a good campus. So that is what I would like to share from my side for you all. So, yes, apart from that, there is another thing which I would like to share with you all which happens at NIPER is the guide selection process. So once you are admitted into MS Pharm program, and then the second step comes is the guide selection. Now, each NIPER has its different set of rules which allows a student to select their guides. At NIPER SS Nagar, the guide selection is completely based on the candidate's NIPER JEE rank. So this gives the candidate a certain authority or rather a certain chance of selecting a lab which they want, right? So that is very much important. So speaking of lab, I would here like to introduce you to my lab. I work at Center of Pharmaceutical Nanotechnology, which falls under the Department of Pharmaceutics at NIPER SAS Nagar. The principal investigator of our lab is Dr. Sanyog Jain. We have actually transferred one technology. We have around 16 patents, out of which 11 are granted and 5 are still in the process. Our lab has published more than 230 publications with more than 9,800 citations. The core research areas of our lab are the oral bioavailability enhancement, transdermal and topical drug delivery, gene delivery via non-viral vectors, co-delivery of drugs, lipid drug conjugates and drug phospholipid complexes, cell cytotoxicity and intracellular trafficking of nanocarriers, multifunctional nanocarriers, and vaccine delivery. Here are the list of extramural projects which our lab currently holds. We receive funding from DBT, Hessian SIT, DST, BIRAC, or for and HINSA and ICM. The major facilities at our lab are the animal cell culture facility, SEM, zetasizer, 16 station Frank's diffusion cell, HPH, freeze dryer, CLSM, auto titrator. To talk about the transfer technology, we have transferred tamoxifen self-emulsifying drug delivery technology for effective treatment of breast cancer to Wavve Life Sciences, Mumbai, for further development and commercialization. We talk about students' achievement just to showcase how well our lab students are performing. Here is a photograph of Mr. Aditya Gupta, who actually got second prize in the North Zone at DRPI 2020. There is the photograph of Tanvi Patil, who received second position in article writing. There is the photograph of our senior most PhD, who got Best Abstract Award at APPS 2019 PharmSci, which was conducted at St. Antonius, Texas. After that, we also participated in National Biomedical Research Competitions at PGI Chandigarh, where, this was for the first time that so many awards from a single lab was awarded. And one of our students from our lab also received the Young Researcher Award 2019 at the same conference. Apart from that, recently I was awarded with the SPDS Young Researcher Award 2021 at DRPI for presenting my research work. So with this, I would like to end my short session. And if you have any queries, I would be happy to answer them in the panel discussion. Or else, if you have any other queries, then you would, please feel free to write me down at my email ID, which has been shown here. With this, I would like to end my session and thank you all for your patient listening.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words.
Now we would like to go further with the event. Over to you, Aditya, sir.
First of all, I would like to ask, am I audible to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I have to ask for liberty because there is one person in the panel because of whom I am sitting here, and he has covered almost all the points. So rather, it is a very good opportunity for me, more than you guys, to share my experience in front of him. So I would like to start my presentation. So is my PPT visible to all of you? Can you see my PPT?
No, Aditya, we
can't.
No? Presentation. No.
It's loading, Aditya.
Yeah, we can.
Okay, now it's visible.
Okay. So it's visible, right? So, actually, Kaushik sir has covered almost all the points. So, whatever points he has missed out or I would like to add, I would like to add in this session. My slide numbers are very small. I know you have been listening to a lot of seminars. So, I would like to keep it simple and sweet. So I am Aditya and I have done my master's from NIPER Hyderabad this year only, 2021. And currently I am pursuing my PhD at NIPER Ahmedabad in the same stream, that is pharmacology and toxicology. Actually, I am still in the process of discovering how better or how good is NIPER Ahmedabad as compared to Hyderabad or compared to any other NIPER. So it is very early for me to give any comments about NIPER Ahmedabad, but I would like to share my experience, 2 years experience that I shared in NIPER Hyderabad. So something which I want to talk about is NIPER Hyderabad, that I have completed my master's in the 2019-21 batch. The current NIRF ranking of NIPER Hyderabad is 6th in India. The placement statistics that most of you will be interested as a career prospect. So I would like to say 90 to 95% of my batchmates were placed from the campus placement. Now every year the statistics change and it is very dynamic. It cannot be constant for any year. And owing to the COVID pandemic, most of the companies chose to you know select candidates online rather than coming in campus and in physical, and that's why the you can see this 5% off campus placements as well when we compare to 90-95% students getting placed from the campus. But very soon this is going to change because now that we are in an endemic stage, I must say. So the placement statistics for last year in my batch was the average salary that was offered for MS Pharm or MTech course was 4.5 lakhs per annum. And the average salary offered for an MBA course was 6 lakhs per annum. And the highest package offered for MS Pharm in my batch was 8.3 lakh that IQVIA company has given, that is a data analyst job in clinical data management. So I'll be talking about specifically about the GPAT and NIPER exam and the pattern, because Kaushik sir has already discussed the basic criteria and everything that you need to get in order to pursue your master's from NIPER. So see, this GPAT or GATE qualification is mandatory if you want to come to NIPER. And if I talk about coming to NIPER or qualifying GPAT, the strategy will vary according to the students. So what I have observed from the last 3 year trend of GPAT is a very subjective and fact-based question paper, as opposed to NIPER, which is not very much different from the GPAT pattern. But NIPER JEE paper is more application oriented and current research trends that are happening with regard to the BPharm concepts. So finding a balance is very essential when you are preparing for such kind of entrances, that you have to give your time equally to both factual as well as concept building. You cannot just study some for your SEM exams and think that if I'm getting a good CGPA, I would definitely qualify GPAT. You cannot prevision that. Because as for 2 years of experience and here in PhD, what I have seen is students who have had a CGPA of 6.5 or 7, they have actually performed way better than us who have got good CGPA in BPharm level. So we cannot correspond that if my BPharm marks is very good, I will definitely qualify GPAT, I will definitely qualify NIPER with a good rank. So you have to find a balance. And talking about NIPER JEE seats for the year 2021, it was approximately 900 seats in the 7 NIPERs, including 90 odd seats for MBA in 3 NIPERs, that is NIPER Mohali, NIPER Ahmedabad, and NIPER Hyderabad. Now, NIPER Ahmedabad has started MBA program just last year. So we cannot say how better or what is the placement strategy or the placement criteria that they are following. But I must add that the MBA faculty here at NIPER Ahmedabad is a faculty from NIPER Hyderabad, who had established the MBA department in Hyderabad in the year 2007. So definitely it will be an added advantage to Ahmedabad. So talking about GPAT exams, it is roughly 500 marks, four marks per question, one minus one for one negative answer. So there are 125 questions in 3 hours. So per question, you roughly get a time of around 1.5 minutes to think. Okay. And when I come to NIPER JEE, there is a sudden rush, like 200 questions in 2 hours. So you have to be very thorough with your concepts and your understanding to solve the paper. So per question you have, if you calculate, it is less than 1 minute. So everything will be in a jiffy. So you can imagine how prepared you have to be when you are giving NIPER JEE as opposed to GPAT. One more point, in NIPER JEE this year, they have shown the marks, what Kaushik sir had mentioned, that they will only show your rank, but that was the trend till 2020, till NIPER Ahmedabad was conducting NIPER. But this year, NIPER Hyderabad has conducted and they have shown the students their marks. So this year, according to this year's paper, the highest marks that I have heard someone, the All India rank one who has got, had scored 75 marks out of 100. Now 100 marks is 200 questions, means 0.5 marks for each question. So you can imagine that fellow must have got 150 correct answers. Okay. If he has not scored any negative marks, he must have 100% attempted 170 to 180 odd questions. And then he has got 150 marks. So you can see how the dynamics changes. For me, in the year 2019, when I first gave my NIPAR JEE exam for my master's program, I had attempted only 130 questions. And my All India rank was 139. So you can imagine how the dynamics and how the marks range can change. So to play with, you have to be at your full. So time is a very important factor. So you need to start practicing the questions in your starting from the third year and till your full final year. So important point while giving your NIPAR JEE exam is to focus on the thrust areas of the conducting NIPAR. Like say if this year NIPAR Hyderabad was conducting. So if you ask any of your seniors from OCP who have qualified, like Jaya and Vartika, these two girls have qualified NIPAR this year from OCP. So if you ask them, they will say that the questions were based from CNS pharmacology. And in medicinal chemistry, there was a lot of organic chemistry based questions and NMR based questions. Because NIPAR Hyderabad focuses on NMR, CNS pharmacology and cancer biology. So you have to see that area also, whether which NIPAR is conducting. You can contact any of your seniors who are pursuing their careers in NIPAR. So one point I would like to say to all juniors is that NIPARs are not the only best institutes in India. Your target should be wide. You can target IIT, BHU, DIPSAR, central universities. They are doing pretty good nowadays. UIPSS, Kaushik has already mentioned. They are doing very good. ICT, JSS, UT and JSS. One more Mysore branch is there. Then you can also opt for Manipal. All of them have their own entrance exams barring IIT, BHU and DIPSAR. Foreign education also can be a good option. You can target North Dakota University, University of Pittsburgh, Nebraska University, Max Planck Center, which is in Germany, and Johns Hopkins University and Sapienza University di Roma. Now, this last university that I have mentioned has produced two Nobel laureates this year, and they have a very high acceptance rate for Indians. Like there are a lot of Indian students who are there in this university. So if someone is planning for a foreign education, definitely you can visit the university websites. These are few universities that I know. And other than that, if you are not willing to go to NIPAR or pursuing your MPharm, you can always have other options like taking up a job or preparing for certain government exams like UPSC, Drug Inspector exams, Railway Recruitment Board pharmacist exam, CGHS pharmacist exam, State Government Pharmacy exam. Because these are also good, equally tough exams as same as GPAT, and they offer good salary and facilities as well. So talking about myself in a short bit that who am I? I have done my BPharm from Oriental College of Pharmacy, and in NIPAR Hyderabad, I was elected as a member of Indian Pharmaceutical Association, Indian Academy of Neurosciences, and International Brain Research Organization. I had received the IDMA JB Modi Award in the year 2020 from the Drug Controller General of India, Dr. V.G. Somani. I have published one paper from my master's, which is in current neuropharmacology. And my master's thesis work is in communication in translational psychiatry nature. Like Kaushik sir has already told about labs and guide. So it is very essential that you fall under a very good guide. So you have to be very proactive from your BPharm days only, like which institute is there and what are the guides they are doing. So now the dynamics is changing. Like I was in Dr. Dandekar's lab. So what my lab does there at NIPAR Hyderabad is we are trying to establish communication between the gut microbiota and the brain axis. So these are two opposite systems in the body. Like if I am talking about the gut, it is peripheral and the brain is the central nervous system. So what we are doing, we are using pre-probiotic and postbiotic approaches to treat neurological disorders like stroke, depression, and traumatic brain injury. I had also received a poster presentation award at an international conference in the year 2020. That was my senior's work that I had carried forwarded and presented in the poster presentation. So while speaking, I should not forget to mention my mother institute that has given me a lot. And I cannot thank OCP enough, because my basic concepts have been built from OCP. And I thank all my teachers and my seniors at OCP for their constant motivation and support that they have given to me in the undergraduate days when it was my foundation years. And if you have any questions or any queries, or if we can be of any sort of help to you guys, you can always contact any one of us who are there in the panel and beyond the panel also, because you have a lot of seniors in NIPER from OCP. So you can contact any one of us and ask for any doubts or anything like that. So once again, I'm very thankful, and I'm very thankful to my seniors, Burhan and Kaushik, who are there in the panel today. They have also been a source of constant motivation and primary standard, if I have to say in terms of pharmacy. They have been a primary standard for me to compare myself and make me better every day. So thank you all for your patient listening. And if you have any questions, you can ask in the panel discussion session. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your intellectual words. Our next panelist for this session is Mr. Abhinav Gupta, sir. Over to you, sir.
Okay. Let me know once you can see my video and audio. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, hi. So a very, I would say, good morning to everyone, because I am sure that everyone has had their lunch and the post-prandial glucose is hitting their systems and they will be feeling so sleepy. So I would request everyone to wake up and listen to everyone, listen to all the panel members. And I just saw that there was a question for Kaushik in his session. So if I would like to request Kaushik or Aditya to answer that question, will that be okay before I begin my session?
Yes, Abhinav, I just saw the question right now. So the answer would be, the pharmacy practice is basically a very wide field in which, it basically deals with the professional roles of pharmacists. Like suppose if there is a new medicine in the market, or there is a new strategy or a new treatment, the therapy which has now been introduced in the market. So their actual work is to collect the data and do a meta-analysis study of each and every, the drug or its interactions. Basically the main thing is that what they do is they go to a hospital, they collaborate with certain doctors of their particular stream, and then they collect the data from each and every patient which the doctor attends. And based on that, they create an hypothesis, or rather they actually either approves or disapproves a particular strategy, which is, whether that is suitable or whether that is benefiting the major portion of the population or not. So yes, basically, so if I want to term their duties in short, it would be like their role is to check whether the therapies are actually acting well onto the humans or not, or to prevent them, what better practices should be followed by the doctors or by the pharmacist. So that is their main role. So I hope I have covered the query and not have introduced many other questions in them. But anyways, I hope her question has been answered well.
Yes, so Snehal, I think your question is answered.
If Snehal is there, she can give us a go.
Okay, I think being quiet means yes. So, Kaushik, you have, I think, two more questions in the chat box. One is about NIPER 2020, who is conducting that exam. Oh, and the other is the difference between PG Diploma and MPharm.
Yes, actually 2022, I don't have any clue who will be conducting NIPER JE 2022. Hopefully it would be NIPER Hyderabad again, but let's see who will conduct. So yes, the second question here is, sir, what is the difference between PG Diploma and MPharm? Yeah, The difference between PG Diploma is basically a diploma course and not then the master's course. but to be okay. to be really frank, actually diploma is way different than the MPharm. Usually the diploma is of 1 year or so, depending on the university in which you are applying. Like the one which I know, is from Jamia. One of my friend who completed his postgraduate diploma in regulatory from Jamia. So that course was around 1 year, in which they conducted online sessions and they conducted exams. So basically, it is a distance learning sort of course in which you get a certificate or a diploma degree in which in a particular subject which you have selected in that university. So like suppose if you are interested in pharmacovigilance, then if you have a PG diploma in pharmacovigilance, then you would be definitely having an upper edge over the other candidates in fetching a job at pharmacovigilance. And say and the same goes with IPR as well as the regulatories and so on.
Right.
Yeah. So I guess there is many other questions.
They're popping up. It's okay.
So actually, shall we address these questions in the panel discussion, or
yes,
shall
sir.
We address
we'll,
it? Yes.
No, we'll okay. keep, we'll take the question answer session at the end only, otherwise the session
okay.
will...
Yes,
that yeah, yeah, fine.
Long. Okay.
So let's
yes,
first
because they...
to Abhinav and Burhan,
yes.
and then we'll take up the question.
So okay. I thought they are shying away from asking the question, that's why I thought maybe address one, but everyone has just started writing all the questions.
Yeah, maybe Abhinav was the catalyst.
Maybe I must have changed my name for that. Okay. So, hi everyone. My name is Abhinav, and I am currently working with a market research firm, which is a global company in the medical devices. So, I'll talk about that more in detail afterwards. And unlike my peers, they have achieved many degrees, and they are highly qualified, and they have shown everything, every details regarding the courses on their presentation. So I don't have any presentation to share with you all. I can just share my face, and I can just talk, and I can share my knowledge with you all. So first of all, I would like to thank Principal Ma'am and Vandana Ma'am for inviting me over here and to be a part of this panel. I feel really privileged to be sitting at my home only, but yeah, sitting with Kaushik and Aditya and all the other panel members. So it's an honor for me. So for starting with this session and for setting up a context with all the students who are sitting at their homes or in their college, why should you listen to me? For that, I would like to give you a brief or a detailed background about myself, like why should you listen to me and why my points do matter. So the short answer is that because I have seen a lot of failures in my career and in my job, in my college also. So that's why, and after every failure, I have stood up and I have achieved many things. I have seen many failures. I have seen many success stories also. So starting from my BPharm, I was an average student, unlike Kaushik sir, who was always at the top of the table. So I was always like a sandwich. I was always in the between, in the below average or the average part of the class. But still, I enjoyed my journey of BPharm. And I ended up getting a job at TCS and also secured another job at Merck. But after that, I also prepared for GPAT. As I think majority of the students are preparing or appearing for GPAT. They must have gone to different classes to prepare themselves for the exam. So even I was a part of those bunch of people. I also wanted to crack GPAT and crack NIPER and sit along with all the scholars and everyone over there. And I wanted to have a job, or I wanted to become a scientist in this industry. But unfortunately, I prepared very much, but I think I fell short of some knowledge or something. That's why I failed. I generally failed in GPAT exam. I couldn't clear that exam. And soon I realized that it wasn't for me, and my interest lied somewhere else. And till that time, I didn't realize that there were many other options available too. So the only one point to all the students who are attending the session is that GPAT, NIPER, NMAT, MBA, these are not the only options which are available to you. there are a lot of options which are there in our country or in the world itself. So please don't fall down or don't get sad if you are not getting, if you are not meeting up to the expectation that you have set for yourself. So that's not the end. That's not the end of your journey. It is the start of your journey. You, whenever you fell down, you have more perspective. As I added more perspective to myself. So after I failed in the GPAT exam, I saw a few people who were preparing for MBA exams. And till that time, I didn't know that there were many entrance exams as NMAT, CAT, CMAT, and there are a lot of other exams which are being given for the MBA colleges. So I just took a mock entrance exam for that. And I found out that I really liked those questions. So the questions for MBA, they revolve around quantitative analysis, logical reasoning, and some tests, puzzles, and everything. So after looking at those questions, it gave me a kick in mind. And I realized that this is where my interest lies in. So I pursued that. I gave the exam, which is called as NMAT by GMAT, which is an exclusive exam for NMIMS University and all the affiliated universities which are there aligned in this exam. So I prepared for that exam for about 2 or 3 months. And post that, I gave the exam in the month of November. And the results came in between December, and I got selected for the campus fellowship. So over that time, when I entered MBA college, I think I'm deviating from the topic. I shall take you through, because this session talks about what are the future career options and education options. So I'll just take you through what are the entrance exams available and what are the criteria to enter those exams, and what are the preparation topics that you should prepare. So I can specifically talk about NMAT exam. So for that entrance exam, the criteria is you should have a bachelor's degree, or you should be awaiting the results of bachelor's degree. And this score, minimum score, should be 50% that you should achieve in that exam. And the first round, which happens between August of any year till November of any year, it happens online. So you have to give an exam of 2 hours, which will have around 120 questions. And the questions will revolve around language skills, quantitative skills, and logical reasoning. So these three are the fit for all the entrance exam which are for MBA in MBA or any college. For language skill, you have to be well versed with all the grammars and English, and it should be very well to pass their exam. And language skills, it basically includes the topics such as vocabulary, parajumbles, fill in the blanks, and correct the grammar, antonyms, synonyms, and there are big paragraphs wherein they'll ask some questions and you have to answer those small pieces by reading the whole paragraph. And the other part is quantitative skills. So in the quantitative skills, the topics will be as cogeometry and mensurations, probability, profit and loss, which are, I think you must have already done this in the statistics chapter of our B-Pharmacy course curriculum. And it also includes number system, pie charts, and many others. And the third and the most crucial one is the logical reasoning. So it mostly consists about topics that are critical reasoning, puzzles, coding and decoding. There will be some pyramids, and you have to change the shape of pyramid according to what will suitably fit the requirements of the question. And there'll be much more puzzles kind of thing in the logical reasoning. So after you are done with these three modules and you are done with the online exam, there will be a scoring system, and the total marks are around 360. And one positive thing about this exam, NMAT my GMAT, is that there is no negative marking. So students are free to, you know, when we give the exams and we don't know any answer, so we just take A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D. So you can do that. There's a freedom for that. Just is it that you need to score a limited amount of marks? When you are sure about all the questions that you know, then after that you can play around with the questions. So after you are done with the exam, the first round will be over, and the results are announced in, I think, January of each year. And if you have cleared the first round, then you'll be called for CP and PI round, which is personal interview and panel discussions. So for that, you have to go to the college, and wherein there will be industry faculty members who are working with companies like Abbott, Novartis, and other big firms in the pharmaceutical industry, and they'll be taking your interview. And the questions in the interview, they generally revolve around why do you want to do MBA, and what were your key achievements in pharmaceuticals in the B-Pharm, and is there any place where you have shown leadership skills, or whatever you have mentioned in your CV or in your resume, you have to give example, or you have to back your statements with an example. That's the key to qualify those exams. So after the PI round is done, there is a GD round, which is a group discussion, wherein there'll be 5 to 6 people in a group, and you have to literally fight with everyone verbally on a topic, and just talk about pros and cons of the topic which is given. And currently the the frequent topics which are there in the interviews or there in the group discussion rounds are available on the internet, or maybe there are NMIMS forums. So you can have a look at those forums and you'll get the topics for all the group discussions. And you can directly prepare for when you are fighting with others, you have to base your comments by facts. So you can read all the facts on the forums as well. So after you are done with the GD and PI round, the final call comes in March, month of March. And post that, you will be given only 14 days to secure your seat, wherein you have to pay the fees and pay the any additional amounts which are there for the hostel or anything in those 14 days. And after that, your seat is secured in the MBA colleges. And I think this is similar to many, many private colleges which are there in Mumbai. Similar is the criteria for entering MBA courses in SIS college, in IAS college. And there are many colleges which offer pharmaceutical or healthcare management in Mumbai. So the same criteria are there in those colleges also. So you have to be well versed with these three skills: language skills, quantitative skills, and logical reasoning. And post that, you can easily secure a seat in MBA. So after that, I think all the requirements for securing a seat in MBA is done. And I'll now talk about what were the benefits in MBA and what will make you transition from where you are sitting right now to a person which you are willing to become. So in MBA, there is no set faculty. Only 10 or 20% of the faculty will be fixed over there. The rest, all the people, all the teachers, all the professors, they are coming from the industry. So in my time, I had professors who were like CEO of Ranbaxy or who were the ex-managers of Abbott and all the big pharmaceutical companies. So they used to come for 2 to 3 months and they used to share their knowledge. So the benefit is that you get exposed to the real world, what is currently happening in the market, how is it impacting the pharmaceutical industry. And in MBA, we get to learn about how money works, how world operates, how the money flows into the system, how it goes out of the system, and how the pharmaceutical industry operates. So in MBA, I think it opened or it widened my horizons from just technical knowledge about pharmacy to wider knowledge about the whole industry. After doing MBA, I got the opportunity to enter sales in pharmaceutical industry, marketing, operations, be it supply chain, and you can also enter the trainings, and you can also go into the strategic division of all the companies. So post that, I think MBA adds more value to your current knowledge, and it's always a required or it's a must to have a good technical knowledge which is set in our bachelor's. So in OCP, I'm sure that all the people who are attending this meeting, they have a very good technical knowledge, because we were also made sure and we were incorporated with all the technical knowledge which was required to survive in the industry. But post that, an additional layering of maturity and corporate culture is needed, which is added by all the institutes like NIPER, NMIMS, and all the other industries, which is required. So post that, I think if you have done MBA and MS or any other post-graduation, then you become more mature. You become more ready for fighting or surviving in that industry. So it's much needed, and it helps. It helps really well to survive in the industry. And the last thing which I wanted to talk about is that the job options are immediately available after BPharm. So I'm sure that out of the 60 or 70 people in the class, only 50 people, only 50% of the people opt or end up going for the higher studies. The rest 50% of the people, they either go for their own business or they join some companies or they just take a break of 1 year and do something else. So for those people who want to do something immediately after BPharm and they want to earn money and they want to add some bread and butter for their family, so there are job options which are available and I have collated the list. So I think Aditya has already touched upon government jobs. Still, I would like to highlight a few which I have seen or have worked with these people. So the first one is the government jobs which are available immediately after BPharm, that is CGHS. The full form is Central Government Health Scheme. And I have seen and I have been working in these centers also in the first year of my career. So there are about 30 centers in Mumbai. It's available in, I think, almost 2 to 3 alternate areas. Like there will be one center available in Vashi, there will be one center in Govandi, Chembur, and a hell lot of centers in South Mumbai. So in these centers, the specialty is that it is specially for the people who are working and who are employed by central government. So all the centers, they have a pharmacy. And each pharmacy has around 3 to 4 people who have to be bachelors in pharmacy, and they need to clear the exam for CGHS. So these the job in this centers, it has clear 3 benefits. First one is that it's government funded and you have job security. Second one is that you come to office, you come to the center at 8 a.m. in the morning, and you can leave, and the job only ends at 2 to 3 p.m. So it's that small amount of time that has been given to the job. And the third thing is that after a few years, you have your own quarters. So government quarters are given to you. You can utilize, you can stay over there, you can move your family over there. And the last thing is the pay. So they pay really well. In the first year itself, when the person qualifies for these centers, the starting salary is 50,000 per month. And it increases gradually at 5% or 7% growth every year. So it's a great opportunity. I would suggest everyone to have or read about this and take a look at it. Second one is the ESIS, which is Employee State Insurance Scheme, which is run by Maharashtra State and all the other states for their own state government employees. And has similar rules and regulations and benefits like CGHS. So you can just read it on the websites. The third is railways. So in Mumbai, we have Railway Hospital, which is in Baikala, and in Western Line, which is in Churchgate. And for those exams also, there are data available, which are there on the online platforms of these railways. And in the hospitals also, there is a requirement of, I think, 8 to 10 people, who half of them are sitting at the back office and half of them are sitting at the front desk, and they deal with the patient directly. So over there also, there is a good scope of the job. And then there are PSUs like ONGC, BARC, and everyone. I have visited the centers of BARC in Govandi and ONGC in Panvel. And I can assure you that the pharmacy, they're having it well-equipped, and the job is very comfortable over there. And they pay really well, especially ONGC. So this was about the government jobs, and I would like to enforce everyone to look at it and read about all these. And then we have already, I think you are all aware of the jobs like pharmacovigilance, medical writing, CRA, QA/QC, our facility or our placement cell members have already ensured that these companies come to the campus regularly, and students are getting placed at these companies. So after that, immediately after BPharm, you can get a role of sales rep, which is a medical representative. I have been in this role for about 1.5 years, and I can assure you that you must have heard only the bad things about being an MR, but there are a lot of good things. I have seen my friends who are in that role. They have bought houses after 3 to 4 years of their career, and that pays really well. And you get to work with doctors and in the hospitals. If you work with MNCs, the job life will be really well. So if you are going into sales, opt for the MNCs like Abbott, GSK, AstraZeneca. These companies are really well. And lastly, there are a few jobs like medical transcriptions, medical coding, scientific writing. The students who are very good with their technical skills and writing skills, they can directly go into these kind of jobs. And the companies which are offering these is Medulla Communications, then Cactus Communications, which is in Andheri, and there are a lot of companies which I can provide you offline after this meeting if you wanted to know. And then there are also jobs in market research industry, which is in interview moderation, survey moderation, and transcriptions. So these are also, there are, I think, 20 to 30 companies in Mumbai who offer these kind of roles as well. So post this, I would like to end my session with the last words. Is that my career has been a lot of failures. I have tried digital marketing and I failed in that. I have tried freelancing. I have tried transcription and I earned really well, but I failed in that eventually at the end. But now the place I'm standing right now is I'm a senior analyst. I handle a team of 5 people in a global firm, which is called CHC Market Research. I handle clients who are based in USA and Europe and the clients like GE Healthcare, Philips, these companies. So I think when I look back at my career, I think I ended up really well, despite a lot of things which I saw. So I'd like to end this by saying that a quote from Steve Jobs, which he quoted in the Stanford speech. Yeah, he said that you can only connect the dots by looking backwards. You can't do it by looking forward. So whenever, whichever place in life you are, just look backwards and see what have you done and what the path you took, and you'll feel really happy with that. So I'm really happy with whatever choices I made. And I feel proud that I was a part of OCP family, and I ended up in a nice place. So that's all from my side.
Thank you, sir, for your knowledgeable words.
Yep.
To continue with this insightful session, we have Burhanuddin, sir, as our next speaker. Over to you, sir.
Hello. Thank you for the introduction. Can I share my screen?
Yes, Burhanuddin.
Yeah. Is it visible? My screen is visible?
Yes.
Yes, Burhanuddin.
Yeah, thank you. So a very good afternoon to everyone who are here. Like, we can see just our past younger selves when we are looking at you all over here, that we also used to be in these classrooms when you used to attend such kind of a career guidance program in colleges and everything. And starting off, I would like to really thank all my teachers and professors, Principal Ma'am Sudha Rathod, Vandana Ma'am, Nutan Ma'am. Like, these teachers are like, we still remember their lectures, the kind of energy and confidence with which they used to deliver the lectures and how well, we still remember them. So speaking of like my personal experience, like when I was during my B pharmacy days, so I had these two options, which I used to only think about. Either it is Masters of Pharmacy, like moving forward with research in your career, or going towards the business aspects, marketing or MBA aspect of the pharmacy career. So then I just retrospected myself that what I'm going to do ahead in the life. And then I just realized that I was not a research oriented person, frankly speaking. I was more interested towards the business aspect, kind of marketing aspect of the pharmacy profession. So that is why I opted MBA in pharmacy from NIPER, Mohali, and I was the gold medalist of my batch. I passed out MBA form in the year 2020. So like there are so many opportunities for you guys that after B pharmacy, it is not just subject to M pharmacy or MS in Masters of Science in any specialization or MBA. There are many other courses like pharmacovigilance. Like, you can also undergo clinical research and work into the CROs. Then there are various opportunities into regulatory affairs, the paperwork, the in-licensing and out-licensing systems. Because nowadays, many pharma firms hire candidates for filing regulatory documents and everything, handling the in-licensing, out-licensing departments, wherein they take care of the import-export scenario in the real world scenario. So I'll just start from basic, like, when, if you plan to give either MS in pharmacy or MBA, Masters in pharmacy or MBA pharmacy, so There are, as being a person from Mumbai, so there are a few choices. Either, like I had this thing in mind that I wanted to do it from another city. I wanted to live like a hostel life. That is why I choose Mohali as the campus. So the colleges which you can go for are Naipur Mohali, Naipur Hyderabad, now Naipur Ahmedabad has also started off. Then in Mumbai, the top-notch institutes from where you can offer MBA in farm are NMIMS, obviously. Then there is also DY Patil, IES Bandra, and IES Bandra and SIS College of for Management Studies. So these are a few colleges from which you can pursue your MBA in pharmacy. Speaking of which, for especially when we come up to MBA from Naipur, so the most important, as spoken by Kaushik, Aditya, that most important thing is GPAT qualification. And after that, scoring a good rank in the Naipur examination. So unlike the MBA examinations, common entrance examinations like the NMAT or the CAT and everyone, in Naipur examinations, there are no much of MBA specific questions. Those are generalized, similar structure for all the students. So you won't find any logical reasoning, quant, quantitative analysis, or those kind of questions in the Naipur examination. If you especially want to opt into the MBA program at Naipur. So moving forward, at Naipur MBA farm, these would be the major subjects which you would be going through. Accounts and finance, economics, marketing, IPR, which is intellectual property rights, regulatory affairs, supply chain management, statistics, and human resource management. So these are the, I know many of you would be like, in pharmacy, we are studying various subjects, and over here, there is a sudden or dynamic change in subjects, but be rest assured, these are very interesting subjects, and it is going to directly going to correlate the pharmacy knowledge into these subjects. So your core pharmacy domain knowledge is very important in these subjects. Second thing I would like to talk about the major job opportunity, because I'll talk about the numbers mainly when you see MBA for the opportunity after B pharmacy. So there are majorly two types of job opportunities. One is the core job opportunities and one is the consultancy job opportunities. Inside the core job opportunities are sales and marketing, then supply chain management, project management, and international marketing. In the consultant, so these core jobs include in various pharma firms where you have to it is a core job of the marketing, supply chain. You have to roam around. Like the basic difference majorly is consultancies are like desk jobs. So in consultancy, various firms are there like IQVIA, TCS, then there is WNS. So these are various consultancy-based firms which employ Naipur students for data analytics profile, forecasting, price modeling, then real-world evidence, then business development, and then business intelligence, which is also known as strategic business insights. So these are the various job profiles after MBA. Now talking about various streams at Naipur. So like talking about various, the MS in Pharm and M-Pharm subjects are very well covered by Kaushik and Aditya. Moving on to MBA, in Mohali, there are 46 seats. And if you see the average placement packages of Mohali is 6 to 8 lakhs per annum. Then when you go for with Naipur Hyderabad, there are 38 seats. And at recently last year, they started with Naipur Ahmedabad, which has 25 seats. So let me tell you guys, like MBA farm at all these three institutes is very well if you opt as an MBA. And I'll tell you the major difference when you see for doing if anyone has a question like why should one go for MBA at Naipur or other institutes like NMIMS or IES or SIS. So the major difference is the fee structure, which I'll just show you all guys. when you see over here the fee structure per semester for MBA is 1,05,000. If you calculate it for a period of 2 years, it is going to come up to 4 lakhs, which is 4,20,000 roughly, which is going to account for everything, like all the hostel charge, most of the hostel charges and everything are included in this fee structure. And if you compare with NMIMS and other colleges like DY Patil, so for NMIMS, the 2 year MBA program fees is going to be between 12 to 13 lakhs roughly, with DY Patil around 8 lakhs, and with SIS also between 5 to 6 lakhs. So this is going to be the fee structure differences between all these institutions. So speaking about like NIPER MBA, so I understand the subjects would are going to be very different, but when you go forward into the business aspect after pharmacy, the first advantage is when you go forward with MBA perspective, you have to see what kind of life you want to live ahead, like either a business perspective, and if you have like, I want to make good money immediately after my master's, so then MBA is a suitable choice, but not just go by the FOMO, like everyone is doing MBA, so I should also do MBA. If you're good academically and if you have a strong interest for research, then you should all think like that, where you want to take ahead, do what you're going to enjoy in the long run. I agree there will be a little bit extra amount of cash over here when you talk about MBA, but you have to think more about how you want to go into the long run. So I understand there will be many questions from your side regarding whatever I said. So I'm really excited for all your questions. And even if there are some students who feel they want to reach me after this session also, you guys can always reach me. This is my email ID and my phone number, and you can also get in touch with me through LinkedIn. So thank you.
Thank you, sir, and all the panelists for your wonderful experience and valuable knowledge. Thank you for sharing them with us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. We are also fortunate enough to have one of our faculty members, Dr. Mahendra Prajapati, sir, an alumni of Institute of Chemical Technology, Matunga. I request sir to take the charge. Over to you, sir.
We are also OCP alumni. There are many faculties are OCP alumni, but only thing is that it's been long back we have completed our PhD, so we are not much aware of the recent trends and rules and regulations. So Mahendra sir would be enlightening us. Mahendra sir?
Yes, madam. Should I take discuss about ICT? Yes, madam.
Student can post your questions in the chat box. Panelists can attend parallel side by side post questions. If you have any query or question, feel free to ask to this panelist. I am very much sure that they do full justice to the questions. Every one of you have nicely prepared the PPTs, nicely prepared the content, and have done full justice to whatever has been allotted to you.
I just paused the meeting, so all the chat has been deleted from my window. So that will be the issue. So,
yes, Mahendra sir.
Yes, madam. Yes, sir. You can listen to me.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, madam, actually, what happened? I just lost from the meeting, so all the chats has been deleted from my window.
Okay,
so I cannot read the questions.
from
no, here. Sir, student will do the needful, sir. Sir, would you like to give some information about ICT MCOM admission procedure?
Okay, madam, just a minute, okay? I will share my screen. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Question answer would be attended by
okay, okay. Okay, madam. Okay, so can you see this Word file, everyone? Madam, please yes, let me know.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
So these are the some of the option after BPharm you can get placed into ICT, okay, for these of the courses. And the first is the MPharm course, and ICT is taking admission into MPharm on the basis of GPAT entrance exam, and this is just a probable cutoff, or not always necessary that the number will be same always. It may be changing, but this is just a scenario from last 3-4 years. Okay, so you can see the All India rank for the different branches, like pharmaceutics it is up to 20 1 to 20, for pharmaceutical chemistry up to 50, pharmacology and medicinal chemistry. Okay, these are the four branches for which ICT is conducting MPharm. Okay, and the fee structure is around 70,000. That is also changing every year. Okay, the number of seats are 6 in every branches, and the students are getting placed into the big pharma giant company like Dr. Reddy's, Cipla and Novartis. Okay, other than MPharm, the ICT also offer an MTech course. For that they are taking the ICT entrance, and the gate is not compulsory. You have to just qualify the ICT entrance exam, and the cutoff for general category cutoff, wise I will say the rank, it is up to 20. Okay, the ICT entrance exam, the fees is again the same. They have the total number of seats are 18 for MTech Pharma, and then again they have started one more courses, MTech MPharm Biotech, for which the total number of seats are 15, and the 7 seats are reserved for the BPharm student. Okay, and the cutoff is up to 50 rank you can get the admission. The fee structure is 40,000. But for that, the entrance exam is the gate. Okay, if you are gate qualified, okay, then you can opt it for this course. Okay, then again, bioprocess technology, again, the entrance exam is gate in the bioprocess, and the rank is up to 50, and the pay structure is 40,000. Number of seats they offer is 30, and then 15 seats are reserved for the BPharm student in the non-pharma courses. Okay, so the half of the seats are reserved for the BPharm student. And then there is oil, flavor and perfumery. Again, there is they are taking admission onto the ICT entrance basis. Okay, ICT is offering interdisciplinary admissions. So they are BPharm student can get into the bioprocess, oils, flavors, likewise. Same from MPharm to PhD, you can come into the different branches. So that is there. Okay, so that is from me. Thank you so much, Vanda madam, for okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, Manindra sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Over to you, Ishwari.
The session is now open for panel discussion. We have some questions from the audience as well. Also, I request everyone, whoever is having any queries, write down in chat box. The questions.
Yes, Ishwari and Vandana madam.
Yes,
may
sir.
I speak few words?
Yes, sir. Please.
Okay. So first of all, it is very nice to listen to Kaushik, Aditya, Burhan, Abhinav, and I am feeling very proud. Actually, because it's a very good thing for a teacher to see his or her students achieving a high in their career and of the field. So I am very thankful to all the panel members and all my dear students for sharing their knowledge. And I'm also thankful to Burhan also, because I have given his number to few of my students as the students are coming to us. Doubts regarding the higher education and the MBA and pharma MBA. तो pharma MBA के बारे में तो आपको ज़्यादा पता होता नहीं at जितना आप लोग जानते हो field में. तो generally मैं क्या करता हूँ कि ब्रह्मान का number दे देता हूँ. अभी 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 नहीं को भी दूँगा अभी. तो thank you very much dear friends for guiding our students time to time and hoping the same for future also.
It's a pleasure, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Said Mateen sir, it's really a wonderful experience to listen to our students.
Yes.
Listen to us for throughout the 4 years.
It's wonderful. And
they really explained very also, nicely all the things.
Aditya also told about the final year students. They are noting down. Aditya told about the NIPER in Hyderabad, I think he told. He asked, they are asking the more question about the CNS pharmacology. So I am repeatedly telling to my students, final year students, because CNS jo hai ye basics humne padhaya hai humko kafi, right from the neurotransmitters and the structures of the brain, all thing I explained them. And I am repeatedly telling them, this is a very a basic thing. And if you are with concentration, you are studying and listening to these lectures of CNS, it will be very, very helpful for your GPAT and other examination, computer examination. And as Aditya told today, the same thing. So, jo meri baat ka to wazan jo hai to badh gaya hai. So, thank you very much, Aditya.
Sir, I could qualify my PhD entrance just because I had studied CNS pharmacology and I was working on that thing in my master's. So, but in NIPER, if NIPER Hyderabad is going to conduct this year also, which is a trend that they follow basically all NIPERs, everyone knows that all NIPERs will have a 3 years time for three consecutive NIPERs they will conduct mostly. So maybe this year also NIPER Hyderabad will conduct. So you can study and you can take Mateen sir really seriously, at least for his all the things that he says that is useful in your other life also. I still remember what he told in first year, that you need not become a very before being a very good student or a scientist, you have to be a good person. So I still remember his words, and respect your parents and everything. And I try applying it till now, sir. So thank you so much.
That is a great gift for our teacher. Thank you.
Since NIPER Hyderabad would be arranging this year's GPAT, this year NIPER exam, so Aditya can throw give some important questions also to the student later on.
I'm thinking to ask Aditya to conduct one or two session on the for GPAT, guiding the GPAT, for NIPER on the CNS and the pharmacology. So if agar ek to session le leta hai Aditya hamare BPharm ke students final year ke, ye bhi ek acha guidance ho jayega bachcho ke liye. Dekhte hain.
And as Mateen sir said na, you have given Burhan's number. Let me also tell you, I also take this liberty of giving the number of alumni to the current batch student, and I tell give Vandana madam's reference. I have that much confidence in my student that listening to Vandana madam's reference, they attend to the query or question put forward by the student. So I also take this liberty to the alumni of even 10 years of bank time. So it was really a wonderful session, amazing session. Nice listening to all of you, Kaushik, Aditya, Burhan, Abhinav. Somehow we are missing Malati Umarji, but some other time we'll connect to her. She is having some network issue in her place. It's a remote place, Guwahati. So she is having some issues. We'll connect to her some other time. Thank you, everyone. Any questions, students? Please ask to the panelists. Let us see how much they are prepared.
Yes, ma'am. There is a question for I guess everyone. Kavita Gupta is questioning that, is there any specific qualification required to give drug test or for drug inspector? There is one question in the chat box.
We'll be keeping a separate session on government opportunities after BPharm. If anyone of you can throw some light, it will be good. Otherwise, we'll be keeping a separate session on that topic. Government job opportunities after BPharm.
As far as
I can answer some part. Yeah. Okay.
Yes,
sorry.
No,
Aditya,
please go on.
So one of my friend was preparing for drug inspector exam, his state drug inspector exam at Himachal Pradesh. So because of this COVID-19 pandemic, they have given the liberty to the students that the basic criteria is there that you must have an industrial experience in Schedule G drugs that are being manufactured. So, and vaccine. So if you have an industrial exposure to these kind of manufacturings, only then you are eligible to write a DI exam for a particular tenure. And for that, first you have to do a job after your B-Pharm, which is very difficult to get in an industry unless you have good contacts and unless you are in OCP, because OCP can guarantee you industrial jobs. So you are at a safe place. So you can do a job for a tenure particular. You can see UPSC and MPSC sites, because I'm 100% sure that Kavita will be giving this DI exam from Maharashtra. So you have to be a registered pharmacist and then you have a certain tenure job experience. Only then you can give a DI exam. And then there are interviews as well, as far as what I've heard from my friend who was preparing. And the question pattern is almost similar to what you prepare in GPAT, but emphasis will be there on Sutics and Cology.
The next question we have from Sakshi Sharma. She says, what is better, a normal MBA or MBA in Pharma? I'd like this panelist to answer it.
Okay, so I think I have already answered that question in the chat box,
yes. But
I'll repeat my answer. So a normal MBA, the advantages that it offers is that you'll be prepared for a lot of industries, be it car industry or any other paint industry or any other industry. But doing an MBA specifically in pharmaceuticals management will prepare you especially for the pharmaceutical industry. And the number of companies that come into the campus, all of the companies will be either medical device companies or pharmaceutical companies or consultancies like IQVIA, ZS, and all the other companies. So the scope or the chances of getting a job in these companies is higher because you have done bachelor's in pharmacy. But when you are doing general MBA, then the scope or chances are lesser because they prefer engineers and other people more over the pharmacists because they need someone in the car industry, so they won't prefer you. So that will be my answer. Go for Pharm MBA.
So there is one more question from Sakshi Sharma. Is after doing MBA in Pharma, make my area restricted to Pharm industry only?
It doesn't, because I have also worked in the other industry. I have done freelancing and worked in the FMCG as well. So it won't restrict you. I have done a job in consultancy for FMCG, so it won't restrict you the scope of your jobs.
Thank you, sir. Any other questions?
The audience, any queries? Japneet says, what should we consider while choosing a subject for M-Pharm along with interest? The question is open to all the panelists.
Yeah, I would like to weigh in. Yeah. Apart from interest, I would rather say the other factor which you should consider while selecting your stream is the industry prospects or your future prospects. Like suppose if you want to pursue your your career in academics, so then it's better that you stick to your stream of interest. And like suppose if your future aspirations are to work in an industry, so then it's better to select a stream which has much more potential of having an industrial applications, like pharmaceutics or pharmaceutical analysis, or for that medical devices. So yeah, it depends on your interest as well as your future goals. Like suppose if you want to do in academics or you want to pursue ahead your PhD, then your stream of interest matters the most. But if you want to continue ahead in an industry, then yes, industrial applicability as well as the current need of the pharma industry should be properly analyzed. I think that would suffice our question.
Kaushik is a very good example of this answer and question. Right, Kaushik? Kaushik was very, very much inclined towards chemistry. And till last few days, I was under the impression that Kaushik is doing master's in chemistry. I recently got to know that as he said, that industry perspective for pharmaceuticals are better if we compare.
Yes. Actually, the chemistry, I mean, I would say yes. I mean, chemistry is a scoring subject. But yes, actually, it all matters up to interest and what I want to pursue ahead. So yes, I had an vision that I want to do these things in future. So accordingly, I selected pharmaceutics as my stream of choice. So yeah.
And did it please switch on the camera side by side so that we can take group photograph? Virtually, group photo is must.
Yes.
Please switch on the camera.
All right.
Students are always presentable to us, don't mind them. Ritika, Omkar, Vishaka, Japneet, Ibrahim, Japneet, Akansha, Neha, Shubham, Sakshi. Switch on the camera first. I know if your photograph is there, then only you will like this post on the social media. So your photo is must in there. Switch on the camera. Placement cell student member, please click some pictures. I am also taking, you also take two pictures. Japneet, Vishaka, Pragya, Fast, Soham, Ritika, Rasneet, Akansha, Nihal.
Okay, thank you everyone. Over to you, Ishwari Atharva. Any question?
Yes, ma'am.
No question. Yeah, it's from Sushma. What to select if someone don't know which stream to go?
Okay. Now that's a difficult one to answer. Okay,
taking name of any one branch will be an injustice for the other branch.
Yes, exactly. So it's better to, I mean, to actually take a pause and think well, before to select a stream. Because eventually what you would end up doing is you would just end up wasting a seat. And more worse than that, you would rather end up a chance for someone else who is actually determined for that seat. So if you are still confused, it's better to take a proper guidance. Reconsole yourself. Self-interpret yourself in which subject you want to pursue or which subject you want as your future, as a future career. So based on that, I think you would be having a certain instinct, within yourself for a particular subject, right? So based on that, I think you should decide, which subject to take or not. Or for that instance, then you could directly go for your perception, like just go for any field at Mohali or at Niper Ahmedabad or at Niper Hyderabad. So if you fall in that category, then you should probably follow your instinct or rather your perception. And if you have a particular inclination towards a field, then yes, you know your way to go.
I would like to add last point, very small. I know the session is getting really long. Like the students who are here, as Abhinav sir has profoundly told that you need not qualify all the exams and only then you can be successful. Similarly, if you are qualified GPAT and you have got a substantial rank for getting admission in NIPER, doesn't mean that only if you get admission in NIPER Mohali, NIPER Ahmedabad or NIPER Hyderabad will suffice. Nowadays, what I can see the trend, and maybe Kaushik will also agree, that the B-tier NIPERs that are NIPER Guwahati and NIPER Raebareli, they are just booming. They are booming day and day. So their faculties are from Naipar Mohali. They are young and energetic. So their research is very much innovative and as per the current need. So it is not that you only land up in Naipar Ahmedabad or Naipar Hyderabad or Naipar Mohali, only then you will be successful. You will be successful even if you land up in anywhere of any part of India. But you just need to have that instinct and that will to perform and do something good.
I totally agree with Aditya. I mean, there are other Naipers as well who are striving hard and in fact harder than already established Naipers. So, Naipar Mohali or Naipar Ahmedabad or Naipar Hyderabad, I mean, can never confirm, I mean, whether you are successful or not. Your success story would only be written by you yourself and not by the institute you choose. So, yes.
So, there is one more question. It's from Ibrahim Reshamwala. What exactly do we need to do in MS?
In MS, you need to firstly, in the first year of MS, you will be having your courseworks. Depending on your stream, you will be, you will be taught certain subjects. So, after that, when you enter into second year, you have to start with a project proposal in which you have to propose, what kind of research or what kind of project you'll be doing for the next 1 year. So in that, you need to perform experiments to validate your hypothesis. And once you have done, then you have to compile each and every aspect of your research in a thesis format. And most probably now in the Naipers, we have a trend that at least in Naipar Mohali, we have a trend that that whenever a master student leaves, he or she has to give us a manuscript in writing, so that we can communicate it for the publications. And similarly, in Naipar Ahmedabad, Aditya would be, Machu would be, knowing about it, that publishing a review article is mandatory for getting their internal marks. So which I think, again, is a very good, initiative for actually motivating students to get, well-versed with the writing part as well as with the medical writing, or rather than medical writing, the literature review part. So to put it in brief, in first year, you will be having courses, and at the second year, you will be doing a research project. And at the end of it, you have to defend your project in front of an external, which will be evaluating you for your final marks.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, audience. Now I would like to request everyone the audience to kindly fill the feedback form given in the chat box, which will encourage us to continue the sessions like this and conduct the sessions like this.
And action will be taken against those who have not filled the feedback form. They'll be marked absent.
Yes, ma'am.
Aise bolna padta hai. Then only we'll get good feedback.
And please, last request from all of you, come to Naipar. We want to give you freshers. All college seniors give freshers to their college mates. Maybe exactly. Kaushik sir is also feeling, and I am also feeling dry every year. I have to give freshers to other Mumbai people who are coming to Naipar Ahmedabad or Naipar Hyderabad. I want someone from OCP to come to Naipar Ahmedabad or probably go to Naipar Mohali so that Kaushik sir can give him a treat, or I can give him a treat if he comes exactly. to Naipar Ahmedabad.
Yes, definitely. I think there is a student from OCP right now in the campus with us. I don't remember his name, but I just received a text from him that he's in campus and he would be happy to meet. I just don't remember his name. He's in campus right now. I don't remember.
Ah, Sunny.
Yes.
He's in BT. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, fine. Thank you all. Ishwari Akarwal, let us end the session for today.
Yes, ma'am. Adding with the vote of thanks. Last but not the least, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude towards the management for motivating us and always being there for us. I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude towards our principal, ma'am, Dr. Sudha Rathod, for being our backbone and motivational support throughout our journey. I would like to thank especially all the panelists for being so interactive and informative. I would like to thank all the members of the organizing committee, faculty members, all the students of third year and final year BPharm. Thank you one and all, and have a great day ahead. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
It was a nice session. And I really enjoyed the session listening to all of you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. And all the students, if anyone requires, ma'am, if anyone is facing any issues, anyone is free to contact us after the session also. Like Vandana ma'am has all our contact numbers and it can be shared freely. No issues. Anyone can contact us with any issue they are facing ahead.
Yes, feel free to take their help and guidance whenever required. It was in session, but when you actually go try for the admissions, at that time, if you require any help, without anyone's name, panelists, anyone will be, any of the OCP alumni will be happy to help our current students and juniors. The culture of OCP, that is what I'm seeing since last 10 years. Thank you, Kaushik, Aditya, Burhan, Abhinav.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Wish you all the best.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank we you, are also ma'am. Missing you, ma'am.
Yes, same here.
Okay, thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Mahendra, sir.
Yes, thank you, madam. I think we stop the recording here and end
yes,
the session,
yes.
Okay?
Yes, sir. Fine, sir. Okay. Take care.